Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to download and install Jupyter Notebook with Anaconda in Windows. So let's get started. First thing, just Google Anaconda, you'll be getting the official link. Click it, and here to the top we are having this free download. Select it, and here we are having the skip registration. Click here, and in the download page, if you scroll down, here we are having distribution installers. So here we are having for Windows, and it is about 900 MB in size, so you can just directly click on download over here, and the download will be getting started. Just be patient till then. Once the download is complete, just open it and you will be getting the Anaconda setup. Just click on next and just read the agreement. Click on I agree and install just for me. Next. And this is going to be the location where Anaconda is going to get installed. I would recommend you to install this in local disk D or E because it kind of occupies a lot of space. So after selecting the location, just select next. And I will just leave it with the default things and click on install. Once the installation is complete, just select next and click on next again. And just select launch. You can just uncheck this one and click on finish. So now after opening Anaconda, you'll be getting the interface. Here you're having so many Python related applications which you can install, like PyCharm and stuff. And as you can see here, we are having Jupyter Notebook, and you don't have to install Jupyter Notebook again because it's already pre-installed like this. So here we are having the launch option. Just click it. And after this, Jupyter Notebook will be automatically launched in your browser, and it's currently running in localhost. And you'll be getting an interface like this. You can just close this. If you want to use the Anaconda AI assistant, you can create an account or sign in. I don't want that. So let me just close this and close this also. So here basically we are having our file structure, like displays all the folders that are present in our system. And we need to choose the folder where we are going to have our Jupyter Notebook file. And in case if you want to go to the dark theme, you can just click on settings, theme, and just select this one. And that's it, you'll be getting the dark theme enabled. So first thing, let's choose a folder. So let me just select desktop. And in case if you want to go back, you can just click on this folder icon again. You can just come back to the original folder views. So I'll just go to my desktop, and here I will just select new and Python. So in case if you want to like upload any notebook file which you already have, you can select upload and just select the location where you have it. It will get automatically opened. So in my case, we are going to create a new one. So I'll just select new, and it's going to be Python. This has created a new untitled .ipynb, which is the extension for Jupyter Notebook, and it's present in our desktop folder. And this one, it's basically like optional. You can just try using this. I will just close this. And here, this is the place where you will be writing your Python code and running. So let me just go with the print statement. It's going to be print hello. So for running, there is like a shortcut key. If you go to settings, and here we are having console run keystroke. So it's going to be execute with shift plus enter. So if I press the keys shift and enter, this will basically execute. And another way that you can execute is you can just simply press the run button. That also does the exact same job. And here we are having few options like AI options. If you click it, this can perform some AI options which comes with Anaconda assistant. You need to create an account. And apart from that, you can move it like below this, move it above that particular cell. And we are having the option to delete this cell. And next is if you go to file, we are having the option to save notebook. It saves it. And if you want to save it in another location, save notebook as, this gives us a different location. You can just do that. And apart from that, we are having the download and save and export notebook as. So we can save our Jupyter file in these many formats. And we are also having the download option. So if you select download, it will be getting downloaded as a .ipynb file. And in case if you feel like the font size is too small, either you can zoom it or increase the font size. So for zooming it, it's going to be control and the plus. As you can see, it's zoomed in, and control and minus zooms out. And now let's see how we can add a shortcut to open Jupyter Notebook, because every time we don't have to open Anaconda to open Jupyter Notebook. So for this, let's just close it and close Anaconda also. Just quit it And now just go to search and type Jupyter. You'll be having this Jupyter Notebook app. You can just pin to start or you can just pin to taskbar. So basically, as you can see here, I'm having the Jupyter Notebook icon. So I can just open it and this will directly open Jupyter Notebook without the need of Anaconda. So as you can see, it's getting opened in my browser automatically. That's the video, guys. I hope you have found it useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.